Good afternoon, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. We begin with those high temperatures out there. It's prompted heat advisories for parts of New Hampshire and have many people looking for ways to cool off, and that included jumping into the sprinkler like this child did in Manchester. Ray Brewer has more.
Holly Michaud looked longingly at one of the city pools in Nashua, hoping to be able to take a dip to beat the heat, only to find the pools closed.
We all wanted to come swimming because the heat wave's coming in. Now we have the bad news that they're not going to open until Monday.
The pools are closed because the lifeguard training isn't scheduled until Saturday.
In preparation for that, all our lifeguards are having recertification for first aid and CPR this Saturday. So we really, for safety purposes, we just don't open the pools until the staff is all certified.
In Portsmouth, though, the water was just fine, and the residents were taking full advantage of it.
I put my legs in there and was freezing cold. After I got in there, for some time I got used to it, and then it was perfect.
At the state's largest city, the pools are ready, and so is the staff.
We hear from our return lifeguards that typically our college students, and they are out of school typically by the end of May, and so we scheduled accordingly.
But the pools will remain empty until tomorrow when school lets out.
I'm so happy that the pool will be open soon. My son can't wait to be the pool to be open. So
until then, Marta Chapanyuk and her 3-year-old son were finding other ways to keep cool. Others, though, aren't so fortunate. For instance, this roofing crew was doing their best by wearing hats and drinking plenty of water and taking other precautions.
We make sure that everybody comes down like every hour, hour and a half. And in the afternoon, if it gets really hot, we'll just pack it in and start again tomorrow early.
And if you are looking for a place to cool off, cooling centers have been open in Portsmouth, Dover, and Rochester. You can find a list by logging on here to our website, WMUR.com. Police in Manchester were on the scene of a bank robbery. Officers were called to the Digital Federal Credit Union on South Willow Street just after 10 this morning. Police say it's the same man, 30-year-old Joel Gordon of Bedford, also wanted for the TD Bank robbery on South Main Street last week. In today's robbery, no weapon was shown, and he got away with an undisclosed amount of cash. Windham police are warning people to be on the lookout for a suspicious man. Police say the man in his early 20s approached two different women in the area, the first a juvenile waiting for the bus. Police say the man drove up and handed her a note saying, quote, "Want to meet somewhere?" Police say a jogger also reported the man after he drove by her slowly several times. Anybody who recognizes this man should call 434-5577. Investigators are looking into what may have caused a vacant apartment building to catch fire in Franklin this morning. Firefighters responded to that one alarm fire on South Main Street around 4 a.m. There are no reports of injuries. Well, a Seabrook police officer used a stun gun to stop a bank robbery suspect on the run. Police say 43-year-old Terry Woodard of Newport, Maine, led Seabrook and Massachusetts police on a chase on I-95 last night after allegedly robbing a TD Bank in North Andover. Police arrested Woodard in Salisbury. He is expected to make a court appearance today. Well, coming up at 5, Mike will be back starting at 5 with another check on the forecast, plus a live look at a packed Hampton Beach. We'll have a live report from there on what is one of the hottest first days of summer in years. And an in-flight emergency, an investigation now underway to find out what went wrong on board a JetBlue flight that experienced a major mechanical failure. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.